Welcome, this is the RPA Champion, and in today's video you champion are going to learn how to do sentiment analysis on tweets. But not just any sentiment analysis on just any tweet, you will learn how to do this. We will basically create a flow that once we run it, we are going to collect the newest tweets about whatever keyword we want. In our case, we're going to be looking for keywords about Trump. We're going to be collecting as many tweets that we want, and we're going to be running different kinds of sentiment analysis on these tweets to see if the tweet is negative, positive, neutral. And we can do this about different stocks, about our favorite movie, about our friend, about whatever we want. So this is pretty cool, especially because to do something so complex that extracts tweets from Twitter automatically, it runs them through a sentiment analysis model and inserts them inside of a sheet without doing any coding. For this, we are going to be using, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be using Power Automate. So sit back in your chair, open up your eyes, clean out your ears, and grab a cup of tea, because we are going to be getting started right now. So if we go to create, and for this we are going to be creating an instant cloud flow. So what this basically means is that we are going to be triggering our flow, or our process, by just pushing a button. Now there's different other ways that we can trigger it, but in this case we're just going to trigger it by clicking a button. Now the first thing that we need to do in Power Automate is add the Twitter connector. So we look for the Twitter connector, and there we search for search tweets. So here we go, search tweets. Here we will put whatever that we want to search on Twitter. We can put this, our favorite stock, if we want to see how's the feeling trending on our stock. We can put whatever we want. Here we also have the maximum number of tweets that we are going to search for. So if you ever wanted to maybe try breaking Power Automate, this is something that you could try to do. We could try doing it as well for this keyword in particular and see what happens. Well, I guess they have predicted this. Let's see if we, something like this could work very well. And well, let's maybe start first with two to see if our process is going to work, and then we can add all of the extra zeros. So what are we doing right now? Right now we are searching on Twitter for two tweets about Trump. Two tweets about Trump. The next thing that we need to do is we need to run them through an AI model. So we need to do sentiment analysis on them. Well, I am not a data scientist or a machine learning engineer, so how should I do that? Well, in Power Automate, you will have this component called AI Builder that has already a pre-built sentiment analysis model. So all you have to do is search for the sentiment analysis model, select the language that you are going to be using, and then put in the text. The text is automatically going to be picked up by Power Automate. It's gonna recognize that you are using the Twitter connector, and it's gonna make the text available. So we're just going to run it on the tweeted text. So what is happening right now? Right now, Power Automate created a loop for us, so it knows automatically that there is going to be more than one tweet. So it's gonna be two tweets. So therefore it has to do sentiment analysis on two texts. So it created this apply to each, which is basically a loop that is going to loop on our tweets, and it's going to do the sentiment analysis on each one of these. Now, what do we want to do? We want to put these tweets inside of our Excel sheet, right? Or in my case, we are going to be using a Google sheet. So let's go to add another action. And to add another action, let's search for Sheets, Google Sheets. So in Google Sheet, what am I going to do? I'm just going to insert a new row. And I will look for the file, I will pick the file that I want to connect to. So I know my file is in my folder Power Automate, and it's called Tweets. Now, once I do that, I need to select the sheet that I'm working on, and once you select the sheet, automatically you will see the different columns inside of your Excel sheet. So if I go back here, you will see user, tweet, link, date, and so on. Now going back to Power Automate, in the user we are going to be putting the username of the person. So let's search for the username. Username is right here. And in the tweet, we are going to be putting the tweet text. In the link, so in the link, I will just be putting the overall sentiment of the text. And in the date, let's see what else we could put. Maybe the probability of sentiment. I think this is fine. Let's just run it like this and see what kind of results we get. So just to recap one more time, we're going to be pushing a button. Once we push the button, we're going to search tweet for two tweets about Trump. We are going to create a loop, run those through sentiment analysis, and then insert them inside of this sheet. Very well, let's save our flow and let's test it out and see if what we have created can come to life or become reality. Let's save it and test, and let's watch the results appear here, if this is going to work, obviously. So it is loading, it is connecting to the different apps. So let's continue and let's run the flow. Now going back here, let's wait for something to appear, maybe the tweets, the user, and the sentiment. Here we go. So we have a sentiment or a tweet from the user tech, and let's check out this tweet. Well, there is words that that talk about violence, so obviously this is a negative tweet. While this other one is neutral. So what would happen right now if, for example, let's change our flow a little bit and let's try to break it. What do I mean by break it? So let's change things a little bit and let's see what happens if we add just a couple of more zero, well, one or one more zero. Will this work or will it not work? Well, there is only one way of finding out. So let's click on save and let's run the sentiment analysis on 2 million tweets about Tesla. Now this is probably, hopefully, is I will have a chance of stopping this, because this is going to be quite a long flow. Now let's see what happens. All right, we have, fortunately, we have had a error. So what is the maximum number that we have managed to extract? I am not quite sure, but we were not able to break in today's episode. We were not able to break Power Automate. We will keep on trying in the next episode. So stick around and see if the next episode we are going to be managing to not just learn something additional about Power Automate, but also to use it in ways that nobody has thought about using it. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like my content and if you would like to see more educative content about Power Automate and also not so much educative content about Power Automate and other things, subscribe to the channel and I will see you in the next video. You are a champion. Thank you so much for watching.